So here we go. Let's compare the output from the really, really cheap power supplies. I just put it to 2 volts, and now I'm in AC mode. So this is 0.1 millivolts of noise. But look carefully about the outputs. 140, 130, 50, something like that. And let's try and take the banana plugs and short them. See? It's a little bit less and it's a little bit more stable. So this is the noise, the internal noise in the amplifiers and the ADC circuits inside the multimeter. So that means any noise under this level we can't really measure because we got noise ourselves, right? So let's plug it back into the cheap one. Have a look again. So it's fair to say that we have 100 and, well, the difference is 40 microvolts of RMS noise from this one, right? Let's look at the DC voltage. Obviously, this one is only specified for 100 millivolts resolution and accuracy and stability and all that, right? Because there isn't any more readout. But we got 4 more digits to reveal any drift and instability. But it's fairly accurate. So let's have a look at this one. I think it costs about 10 times as much or something like that, right? As you note, this is actually drifting a little bit, and I think this has something to do with the regulation. So there is a little bit of low frequency movement of the output due to its regulation loop. It's not really noise because I can't detect it in here. Or, look at this, the output is jumpy, right? So this must be due to the low frequency, low frequency modulation or noise or something, instability. And again, let's try and short circuit the banana plugs. Now they are still inside the power supply, just to prove that there's no unit to unit current or anything. Everything here is on earth and all that. So if I try and pull this out, they are now shorted together, right? And I pull it. And plug it into the ground one. So we have no ground loops or anything like that. All right. Thank you for watching.